Good afternoon and thank you, Governor. As former municipal officials, Governor Baker and I recognize the strength of our economy depends on the vitality of each and every one of our 351 cities and towns. Since entering office, we have been proud to work closely with our local leaders to identify and solve the unique challenges facing their communities. Today, I'd like to highlight some of the resources our administration is providing to support municipalities and Main Streets as we continue to fight COVID-19. As the governor said, the pandemic has been especially challenging for our downtowns and our town centers, as well as the businesses that comprise them. In response, we launched recently the Shared Streets and Spaces program to help communities adapt and support local businesses, and we've in fact toured and visited some of these places to see the creativity and the innovations and the redo of some parts of our downtowns and Main Streets. Cities and towns have demonstrated their creativity in leveraging these relatively small dollars to really make a difference by installing barriers and infrastructure to promote safe outdoor dining and experiences in parking spaces and places that you normally wouldn't see seating and tables. So far, more than $10 million has been awarded to fund 124 projects in 103 municipalities across the Commonwealth. So building on the success of this initiative, and part of the success is attributed to the design of the program being easy to apply for and a fast turnaround of the dollars to get to the end consumer, we are announcing that an additional $10 million in Shared Streets and Spaces funding will now be available to our municipalities. In our constant discussions with local leaders, we are also identifying the need to create plans tailored to the challenges facing their communities. So as a result, we are launching the Local Recovery Planning Grant Program, making $10 million available directly to all municipalities as they develop and implement their plans to ensure a strong recovery in their community. Using the Department of Housing and Community Development's Mass Downtown Initiative as a vehicle, these grants will support these planning efforts, such as local market assessments, marketing strategies, systems upgrades, and the redesign of public spaces to allow for improved social distancing. We look forward to continuing to work closely with our local partners to help them implement these plans and ensure that every community has the resources it needs now more than ever. In addition to these new grants, we plan to leverage more than $115 million to existing capital programs towards small business and downtown recovery for our communities. This includes more than $100 million in the MassWorks infrastructure funding, as well as a collective $10 million in brownfields, site readiness, and the Transformative Development Initiative and Collaborative Workspace funding. So all different programs that community officials are very aware of and have been very resourceful in stacking up to bring these dollars to their communities, and we'll continue to work through that with them. These programs already, as I've said, play a key role in strengthening communities of all sizes, rural, suburban, urban, all across our Commonwealth, and they will be critical to the recovery in our communities. Our administration also recognizes the new challenge created by the shift to remote work and education caused by the pandemic, which so much of our business and educational activity is now taking place. So reliable internet access has become essential. To ensure widespread, equitable access to the web, our plan offers $9.2 million in new funding to support internet connectivity across our Commonwealth. This includes $6.2 million to extend and expand the Massachusetts Broadband Institute's existing hotspot program, which provides internet access to unserved and underserved areas in Western Mass. This service, announced in April, provides free internet access to unserved and underserved areas in the Western Massachusetts area, giving residents the resources they need to conduct business and attend classes. The plan also includes $2 million to create a cellular hotspot Loaner Program, as well as $1 million to provide internet access and devices for populations in need. We need to make sure that in a virtual setting, people stay connected to learn and to work. So altogether, these investments will provide municipalities with the resources they need to support a strong recovery for all. We are grateful to the continued partnership of local leaders and look forward to working together to come out of this stronger than ever.